organized. You know, a lot of people think GTD and this methodology is primarily about getting organized. It's not really. I understand why people say that, because a lot of people's systems and their organization and their structures really haven't kept up with their creativity and their commitments. So most people, that is a big improvement opportunity to essentially get more organized. But it doesn't mean constraining yourself. It doesn't mean creating inappropriate structures. Heavens no. I mean, I'm into freedom. I love the structure in the road that has lines in it, so I don't have to worry about people hitting me when I'm out on the road. So that's what I mean by having structure that creates freedom. So freedom for me, for instance, the fact that, you know, here's my in basket that has all the stuff today that's shown up, today's mail, receipts I generated this morning. And I just love the freedom to know that that's all there. It's nowhere else. I know exactly what that means. That's where those things go. Here's support material for things that I need to, I'm waiting for, things I need to move on. Here's just reading material. Here's my tools that I have for taking notes. The current book I'm reading, you know, my electronic gear charging up here at the desk, my labeler, you know, files that basically are my support files for projects that are, I'm going on, or things I want to have at hand, like, you know, a place to throw my receipts, the business receipts, once I've processed and cleared them. And, you know, it's in a sense really that simple. You know, obviously on the computer I have the organization of things that I need to see. So organizing just means let me put stuff, once I've decided what it means, into some place that I can then utilize that appropriately, so my brain doesn't have to keep rethinking what does it mean, where is it, and so forth. Now my brain can be freed up to just make good decisions out of these various things. So I have the freedom now to move around and not be distracted. If I were to pile all these things up together, if these things that just came in were in the same pile as these, with along with my book, along with, you know, these other files, I would just go numb and unconscious to these things and essentially have a stress about them simply because they weren't in their right place, and some part of me is still having to rethink what they mean every time I look at them. And I frankly don't have the energy to do that. So what happens is we go unconscious to those things, or we go numb to them. And, you know, that's not very healthy. And then what happens is things fall through the cracks. We don't know where to find them. So come on, I'm sure this is common sense to you. But much like you have spices in your spice cabinet in your kitchen, you have socks probably in a sock drawer where you know where to get socks when you need socks. As simple as that is, that's really all this is. Once we decided what these things mean, then I park them where they go so that my brain is not still trying to manage that in that way. It's freed up from it. So organization is really about freedom, not about constraint.